Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm here for the purpose of gathering. The festival of lessons and carols is a service of scripture and songs that date to the late 19th century. In this service, we listen to nine scripture lessons, which recounts the promise of a Messiah, the incarnation, and the great commission to preach the good news. Each lesson is followed by a carol or other song that reflects on the lesson's message and a brief prayer. Thank you.
Thank you. Bible reading. Our first lesson will begin from Genesis chapter 3, verse 8 to 19. Then we'll call on our sister Goodness. Let's clap for her. Good evening. Our first lesson will be taken from Genesis chapter 3, verse 8 to 19. God tells sinful Adam that he has lost the life of paradise and that his seed includes the serpent. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told thee thou was naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee not thou should not eat? And the man said, The woman whom thou gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above the cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and thou shalt not eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise the head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. And unto Adam he said, Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of the wife, and hast eaten the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, Thou shalt not eat it, because cursed of it ground for thy sake, and sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of thy life. Thorns also empty still shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. In the sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread, till thou return unto the ground, for out of it was thou taken. For that thou art, and unto that shalt thou return. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Amen. our second Bible reading. And that will be taken from Genesis chapter 22, verse 15 to 18. Our sister Ivy will lead us. Let's give a mic to her.
God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. And the angels of the Lord called unto Abraham out of the heaven the second time, and said, By myself I have sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast said, thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld my son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sun which is upon the seashore. And thy seed shall possess the gates of his enemies, and in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Thanks be to God.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
our third Bible reading. And that will be taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2, then 6 to 7. Our sister Jennifer will lead us. Let's go.
Praise the Lord. I present to you the third lesson from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, then 6 to 7. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them has the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Thanks be to God. Amen.
His roots, and the spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord, and shall make him quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. With righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity of for the meek of the earth. The wolf also shall go with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and the little child shall lead them, and the cow and the bear shall feed their young ones with, and their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox, and the sucking child shall play on the pole of the ass, and the wind shall and the weak child shall put his hand on the cockatrice thing. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the earth, for the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
Doesn't matter what you say. I'm not afraid of the dark.
to our faith Bible reading. And that will be taken from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verse 26, 25, then 38. Our sister Anita will lead us. Let's clap us.
Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call him Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
so much as Sister Dorit. We're having our sixth lesson, and that will be taken from Luke chapter 2, verse 1, and then 3 to 7. And this will be taken by our associate pastor, Richard Baldwin.
It's an honor to present to the sixth lesson. Our sixth lesson will be taken from Luke chapter 2, verse 1, and I'll proceed from 3 to 7. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went out from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of the and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Thanks and glory be to God. Amen.
Country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a baby wrapped in a swaddling clothes, lying in the manger. And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them unto heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord has made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the baby lying in the manger. The word of God. Amen.
Two.
Matthew chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judah, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judah, for that is it written by the prophet, and thou Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people. Israel. Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring him word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east was before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and confits and myrrh, and bring word of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod. They departed into their own country another way. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Christ the Savior is born. We're coming to an end of our program. And our ninth lesson will be taken from Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 14, by our sister AC now.
Lesson is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14, and I read. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighten every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born, not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. This ends our night. Thank you.
Rules the world with truth and grace, and may